UV curve is very useful tool in Rhino 3D modeling, and I've been using it in many different applications. Hi, I'm PJ Chen, an authorized Rhino 3D trainer. We would like to discuss today how to use the UV curve, what it is, and the difference between applied UV curve compared to flow along surface. Let's get started. Let's go ahead to create a cylinder. We're gonna use the solid tool, and in this case we're going to type it 20 and height for 10. I'm using millimeter as my unit, and I'm gonna turn into the Gauss view. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're going to put the word around this cylinder, you know, on the side, and I need to know like how what is the dimension of them. So what I'm going to do is you go into the curve, and you have curve from the object, and right here you have create UV curve. Now in the command bar here, to asking you select the surface, so we are going to select this surface, and then we're gonna hit enter. So now you have here, it is if this cylinder is flattened out and this circumference where you see on the side of the wall, if it is flattened out, it will be in this area. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're going to use the word, I'm just gonna type it create UV, and in this text we can use the curve surface and solid. I'm gonna show you two way to build the same thing. I'm gonna use the solid first. Okay, so create a UV. Now they are a group. I want to make sure they are aligned. So I'm going to using the align tool to align right there. So now here is create UV. All right. So how are we gonna put this create UV text and around this surface is the command we're going to use, flow along the surface. Before we do that, we need to give it a reference. So this is our reference, but it has to be a surface. Well, we're gonna turn it into the surface by surface from planar curve command. So once we put it there and the text is actually sitting exactly on top of the surface. Okay, so what we're gonna do is go into the transform. You have here flow along surface. So we are going to pick up the object we want to flow, and we are going to pick up one of the corner on this base surface, and then we are going to come in here to pick up one of the corner and happen to be inside. The reason is where on the edge right here is where the seam here. So I was clicking on left side of the seam, and that's why it going to inside. So we're gonna redo, and we're gonna use the same command again. I'm gonna click on the same corner, but this time I wanna click on right side of the seam. So you can see we have this create UV curve. So I'm going to move it right here. This is done by flow along the curve. Okay. Second way I'm going to do is going to do the same things. We are going to use the text, and this time we're going to use the curve instead of solid. Okay. I'm going to put the curve here and kind of line up by center them. Okay, so this time the command we are going to use, since they all curve, and we are going to use curve from the object, and you have one is called apply UV curve. Okay, it's going to select the curve, it's going to apply to that surface, and then we pick up the surface, and this time we want to pick up here. Oftentimes they will be upside down. So what we like to do, and you also notice that C and the V is really, really close, is because I did not choose the outside frame. So this time what we like to do is we're gonna rotate it 180 degree. And this time I wanna choose the outside frame. So I will make sure that has the distance in between C and the seam. Let's do it again. Curve, apply the UV curve. This time we wanna select all the curve, hit done. And then we're gonna come in here to pick up this corner. Then we will see this this curve is applied to that surface, okay? So I'm going to delete the curve that we don't need, and I'm gonna select all the curve at once. Let's go ahead to trim the surface. Make sure to trim those inside like E and A, the middle part. Okay, once we trim in, now we have all the surface, individual surface. Okay, so what I like to do is I'm going to offset the surface. We are going to pick up those surface and we're gonna hit offset. In this case, since we're gonna make something exactly the same, we're gonna offset 1 millimeter and make sure solid equal yes. This is quite important here. If you click solid equal no, you will only come up with the surface. So you need to make sure solid is equal yes. So let's do again, solid equal yes, 1 millimeter, and this is how we get it. They are looking very similar. To create in this application, either way will be fine. They both are very good tool to use. Either with this one is a flow along the surface, and this one is done by apply UV curve. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please like, comment, and share my video. That helped me to create more free video for you. And please don't forget to subscribe it. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next time.